Hey everybody, today we are making vegan breakfast tacos. We'll be doing one in a traditional way, as well as a taco inspired by Sonic the Drive-In, not the Hedgehog. And lastly, we'll be doing one in the style of a California burrito. It's worth noting that I'll be using a bunch of convenient products, such as these, since I'm making a ton of tacos all at once. However, if you want to make your own potatoes, vegan bacon, or carne asada from scratch, check the links in the description for videos on how to do just that. But for now, let's make a couple of toppings, and first up is some pickled onions, which are quite easy. All we need to do is slice up some red onions nice and thin, add them to a jar with some garlic and black peppercorns, and then we're going to get equal parts water and vinegar, add in some salt, and we're going to heat that up to a boil and then cover our onions in it, and then we just need to seal that up and throw it in the fridge for a couple hours. Next, let's put together a quick sauce that has become my new favorite. We'll start with 1 cup of vegan mayo, 3 cloves of garlic, half an avocado, a bunch of pickled jalapenos, and then a good handful of cilantro, and some lime juice to taste. I used 2 limes and it was pretty dang zippy. And speaking of zip, I'm also adding in 2 teaspoons of tajin just for good measure. After that, we just gotta blend it up, and as soon as that's done, you are left with one of the best sauces you ever did eat. I'm calling this a tajin aioli because why not? And honestly, it's good on everything, but mostly these breakfast tacos. Now, of course, what sets a breakfast taco apart from a regular taco is typically the inclusion of eggs. For these, I'll be using just egg for my tacos. However, let's go ahead and whip up a quick tofu scramble as well in case just egg is not your cup of tea. And all we need to do is get a block of extra firm tofu, and somebody told me they don't even press it for a scramble, so let's just crumble it straight into the pan. And then next, let's just cook off some of that tofu juice, which will only take a few minutes. After that, we'll season it with some nutritional yeast as dictated by vegan law, of course. And then I'm gonna use some of this adobo seasoning since it has basically the same stuff I usually use to season my tofu scrambles. So stir that around, and then I decided I'm going to need some turmeric for color and health. Now, another thing somebody told me that they do instead of adding plant milk is they just stir in some silken tofu. Well, I could only find soft tofu, so I gave that a try, and I gotta say, I think I like it better than plant milk. Eventually, I ended up using the entire block, but I just started off with about 1/3 of it, and then I added in more as I saw fit. And then I added in some black salt, which, if you don't know, makes things taste like eggs, which you may or may not like. Some people think it tastes like feet or worse. After that, I threw in some more black pepper and salt, and that's basically it. And now I have a ton of tofu scramble left over, and I can whip up a breakfast taco whenever I want. Speaking of which, let's make a breakfast taco in the traditional style. We'll be making some of these potatoes, some just egg, some cheese, and then I'll be using this hooray bacon. I've used it before and I thought it was okay, but I wanted to give it another try. But these potatoes took way longer than I had expected, like I might as well have made them from scratch. Next time I might try to air fry them since that would probably do the trick. But either way, I went ahead and seasoned them up with some seasonings like garlic powder, chipotle powder, smoked paprika, salt and pepper, and they actually came out really good. A little crunchy, but honestly, it worked out great in contrast with the just egg. And now, time to cook the hooray bacon, and let's do a little time lapse. And this stuff really does cook like how I remember non-vegan bacon. Pretty wild stuff. I do think it's good, but I wish it was a little cheaper. Maybe it'll come down in price the way just egg did. And speaking of which, time to cook that up. And this stuff totally cooks like how I remember chicken eggs. Also, totally weird wild stuff. I seasoned mine with some salt and pepper. Some people say they like to add black salt, but personally, I don't find that it needs it. Once our eggs are done, I'll go ahead and throw a tortilla straight on the stovetop and warm it up. And now that all of our components are done, it's time to build our taco. So let's add some of our really crispy and seasoned potatoes, followed by some of our just egg, and then next, the vegan bacon. And last but not least, I'll grate over some of this Daya cheddar block. And there you go, a bacon, egg, cheese, and potato taco done up like they do it in Austin, Texas. So now, it's time for a good old taste test.
Let's try a bite. It's perfect. I mean, the bacon and the potatoes are crunchy, and then you've got the scrambled eggs that are nice and soft. I mean, there's a reason why this is one of the most popular breakfast tacos. Let's see how it is with a little bit of that green sauce that we made. Just a little bit. All that salty crunchiness contrasts perfectly with the kind of limey spiciness of that sauce. It's hard to think that we might be able to top it, but let's try. Next one.
All right, next up, we're gonna do a taco inspired by Sonic, and this taco has tater tots in it, which is always an excellent move. I'm gonna air fry them, and while that's happening, I'll be making some of this new Impossible sausage, which admittedly didn't look so great at first, but once I broke it up and cooked it through, I gotta admit, it's pretty freaking good. Totally reminds me of breakfast sausage. And once that's all nice and browned, I'll scooch to the side and cook up the just egg. And then now it's time to assemble our Sonic taco. So start off with some of our tots, a smattering of that breakfast sausage, a bit of our just egg, some pickled jalapenos, some of that Daya cheddar cheese, and there you go, a supersonic breakfast taco. And now it's time to dig in.
All right, here we go with the Sonic style. Let's see if I can get this thing in my mouth. Let it be known, tater tots, best thing to put in a breakfast taco. I don't know if it's controversial, but it's my opinion. So that's what I'm gonna go with. This is amazing. The Impossible sausage is perfect. The tater tots are perfect. I'm gonna put, like I did on the last one, a little bit of this green sauce. Okay, so that first taco, the traditional one, that was super good. This is twice as good, at least. Holy mackerel. All right, on to the next one.
Last but not least, let's do a California style taco, and this is based off of a California burrito, which if you don't know, features carne asada, fries, cheese, guacamole, and sour cream. Just like with the tots, I'm gonna employ my air fryer for these fries. And for the carne asada, I'll be cooking up some of this Gardein beef. And once it's gotten a bit browned, I'll go ahead and season it with some cumin, garlic powder, smoked paprika, chipotle powder, salt and pepper, you know the drill. I'm not measuring anything, just sprinkling on enough to coat it. And then I'm gonna squeeze in some fresh lime juice, stir that around, and bam, there's our Lazy Person's vegan carne asada. And after we cook up our just egg, it's time to build our taco. So start off with our fries, the just egg, our vegan carne asada, some of that Daya cheese, if you please, and then in lieu of sour cream and guacamole, I'm just gonna use our tahine aioli. Hey, that rhymed. Because I do what I want. And then, breaking with tradition, I'm gonna top it with the pickled onions, and I'll be totally transparent, I made the pickled onions to use on a fourth taco, but I was already super full, so I wimped out, so sue me. But as you'll see in this next taste test, it totally worked out.
All right, here we go with the California style taco. Mmm. Wow. I know I just said the Sonic one was my favorite, but this one might be my favorite now. Hold on, let's try another bite. The carne asada is seasoned in a way that elevates it, especially in the pickled onions. I don't know. This, I think, it's kind of a toss-up. They're both really good. Either way, you really can't go wrong with either the Sonic style one because of the tater tots. This one, the French fries, ain't no slouch either. So really, I would highly suggest making either of those. You can also make a breakfast burrito. I've got a link right here. There's a lot of other links in the description to help you out making any of your bacon or tofu scramble or anything that you like. If you do make them, let me know how it went. I hope you're all doing great, and I'll see you next time.